And I'm all set to attend a wedding, just that I don't have a wedding to attend. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, welcome back to yet another video. I hope you all are doing fine and you have read by the title what today's video is going to be about. So it is November and the wedding season is on. I'm sure you all will be having a list of weddings to attend this season. So today I am going to be sharing one makeup look, and also the look is going to be really simple. Now before we begin with the makeup look, if you're watching my video for the very first time, hi, my name is Soni Mishra. I post beauty and lifestyle content here on my channel. So please take out a moment and subscribe to the channel down below. And don't forget to hit the notification bell right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. And I also post beauty content on my Instagram, so head over there and follow me there as well. Now without any further blabbering, let's just dive right into it. So I've already washed my face. Now before beginning with the makeup, I will moisturize my skin. And for that, I am using the Cetaphil lotion. Now I will apply a lip balm on my lips. So firstly, I will be using primer. I will be using two primers today. First, I will use the Colourbar Perfect Match Primer. It is a silicone-based primer and it helps to fill in the pores. So I will be applying that to my T-zone. And the second primer that I will use today is the Swiss Beauty Real Makeup Base Highlighting Primer. So it is more like a strobe cream and it will give my base a dewy effect. So I will apply it to the high points of my face. So you can see it has given me a very beautiful glow. Now I will color correct my skin. So I have some acne marks here and there. So I will color correct it using the Insight Makeup Essentials Pro Concealer Palette. And I will take the orange color corrector on the back of my hand. And I will mix it with some concealer. And for the concealer, I'm using the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind. So I will mix the color corrector and the concealer on the back of my hand. And now I will dab it on the areas that I have marks. Color corrected all the areas that I had some spots on, and now I will apply a layer of foundation. And for the foundation, I'm using the Maybelline Super Stay Full Coverage Foundation. So because it is a wedding look, I will be using a full coverage foundation, but you can obviously go on for whatever foundation you like. I will take one pump of it on the back of my hand and dot it all over my face, and the remaining I will take it down to my neck. Now using a damp beauty blender, I will spray some setting spray and blend the foundation. I am done blending my foundation, so the next step will be concealer. Firstly, I will be taking a concealer that is exactly my skin tone and I will apply it little bit on the areas that need concealing and a little bit on my under eyes, and again I will blend it using the same beauty blender. Now I will be using the e.l.f. 16R Camo Concealer to highlight my under eyes. So this concealer is lighter than my skin tone, so I will be using it for highlighting. Now my under eyes are all concealed and highlighted. Now I will pack in the base using a loose powder. And for the loose powder, I'm using the MARS Trend Setting Powder. Now using a small brush, I will dust the powder all over my face, especially setting my under eyes first. I will not bake my under eyes, rather I will press in the powder. And for the rest of my face, I will use a large powder brush and I will lightly dust the powder all over my face. So now is the time to give some dimensions to my face. So I will bronze my face, and for that I'm using the Sugar contour de force face palette in the shade 01 subtle summit. I will be using the same small powder brush to contour my face. I'm now using a smaller brush to contour my nose with the same bronzer. For blush, I am using the iMagic Professionals Touch Blush Palette. I will be using these two shades, Damsel and Sweet, and I will be mixing both of them together. This palette is really pigmented, so I'll dust off the excess and lightly brush it over my cheekbones. So the blush is applied, and now I will go all over my face once with the Damp Beauty Blender just to blend in all the powders together. So my base makeup is almost complete, and now I will move on to my eyes. But before that, I will just spray a little bit setting spray so that all the powders are blended in together and does not look powdery. So it is almost dried down. Now while it dry down further, I will do my brows, and for the brows I'm using the PAC eyebrow pomade. I will use a spoolie to brush up my eyebrow hair and use the pomade to fill it in. So my eyebrows are done. Now I will carve them out using the concealer, and I will apply the same concealer on my eyelids to prep them up for the eyeshadow. I will blend it using the concealer brush. I'm taking little loose powder on this brush and patting here so that the concealer is set in place. So it's time for eye makeup now. And for eye makeup, I'm using the iMagic Professional Chalice eyeshadow palette. I will take the lightest brown shade and I will use it as my transition color. Now I will be using this muted plum shade and I will apply it on my crease. I will deepen it a little bit using this purple violet shade on the crease and the outer V, just a little bit to give the dimensions. Now I will blend it all together. Now I will use this Swiss Beauty liquid eyeshadow in the shade 01 Gold Goddess, and I will apply it like a half cut crease. Now taking a little bit of the violet shade mixed with the plum shade, I will go on over my crease once again and blend the harsh line. Now using a blending brush, I will take that lightest brown shade and I will blend it all together, creating a transition in small circular motions. So the eyeshadow is complete. I'll do the same on the other eye. So I did the same on the other eye. Now I will take a small flat blender brush and I will take the same plum shade and apply it under my eyes on the lower lash line and lightly deepening it towards the outer edge. Now I will take a pencil brush and using the Swiss Beauty liquid eyeshadow, I will apply it a little bit towards the inner corners on the lower lash line. Now I will line my upper lash line, and for that I will be using the e.l.f. Cosmetics liquid liner. So I did a thick wing liner today, and now I will line my waterline using the color bar coal pencil. I will concentrate it more towards the outer corner and not take it completely inside. And with the help of a small brush, I will smudge it a little bit. So I went for a bold eyeliner and kajal look, and the eye makeup is complete. And now I will highlight my face. For that I will use a small brush and I will highlight the high points of my face. Now I will spray a little setting spray onto my sponge and I will dab it lightly once all over the face. Now I will curl my lashes. If you want, you can go ahead with false lashes, but I am skipping false lashes for today. And I will curl my lashes and apply mascara. For mascara, I am using the Maybelline Hyper Curl Waterproof Mascara. I am using the Nykaa lipstick in the shade Daydreaming. Yeah, the look is complete and I'm all set to attend a wedding, just that I don't have a wedding to attend. Never mind, I hope you all like this makeup look, and if you try out this look, please tag me on your Instagrams. This is my handle. Follow me there for more beauty content. And with this, I will end today's video. I hope you liked the video, and if you did, please consider hitting the like button and share this video with your friends and families. And the most important thing, don't forget to subscribe to my channel down below. Click the red button and the bell right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. And comment down below if you want me to do any other makeup look or any other video for that matter. Now I will see you super soon in my next video. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye bye.